fall in love too easily. I'd fall in love.
It's Sunday. I have some painting homework to do. Me and my friend are going to brunch today. I'm very excited. I have not been outside, guys, like basically all year, so excited to see my friend, catch a little vibe, have a little mimosa, and chill, so I guess you can come along with me. First, get dressed. I don't know what I'm wearing, but we gonna figure it out. Do some little makeup and catch a vibe, so let's get to it. Really get to it, yeah. As you can see, I have made it in the car. Honestly, me and my collar drooping like a mug. Hold on, y'all. I'm driving, so I'm trying to be safe at the same time. So I feel like my makeup could have went harder, but I'm not mad at how it looks right now. Like, I feel like I did a good job, to be honest. Yeah, so now I'm gonna head to Ashley's house. I am running 8 minutes behind. Not bad, but you know, I could have hustled a little harder, I guess. That's where we're at, and I will catch up with you soon. This is the part where I decided to do a voiceover. Yeah, I decided to do a voiceover because this was an extra long video and I didn't want it to be an hour and a half long, so I just fast forwarded it and we're gonna take the time to talk about self-love, you know, the vibes. And honestly, at this point in my life, like, I've really been struggling with self-hate and just like not really appreciating myself because of some personal things that I'm going through, and being in school this whole time has all just been very eye-opening for me. But I've learned that self-hate is a corrosive force that basically eats away at our every essence. Like, it blinds us to our strengths, it magnifies our flaws, and imprisons us in a cycle of negativity. When we hate ourselves, we deny ourselves the basic human need for compassion and understanding, which is something that I've been struggling with. We deny ourselves, you know, just the basic necessity of love, and that's why it's been such a struggle for me in school and my art career, because I've just been, I don't know, struggling with this feeling of imposter syndrome for some reason. Like, I am not doing things the right way, or, you know, this is not who I really am, or why am I learning art if I'm not an artist, and, you know, just things like that. But choosing self-compassion over self-hate has really opened the door for my growth and healing. It allows me to acknowledge my imperfections without condemning myself. Instead of dwelling on my faults, I can focus on them and understand them, learn from them, and embrace my sense of humanity. Self-compassion acts as a guide. This acts as a guiding light through difficult times, offering solace and acceptance. It enables us to treat ourselves with the same kindness and empathy we extend to others, fostering a nurturing environment within our own minds. Embracing self-compassion doesn't mean ignoring areas we need to improve. Rather, it provides a supportive foundation from which we can grow. It encourages us to acknowledge our mistakes, learn from them, and move forward with a sense of kindness and understanding toward ourselves. I don't know, I just feel like ultimately self-hate is a barrier to self-discovery and personal development. And that's why I'm so focused on loving myself, because it's so easy to hate yourself. Like, I've learned, especially in modern day society with social media and everybody being on their phones and just tapped in and not really paying attention to what's in front of them, but, you know, focusing on what's going on online, it's so easy for people to hate themselves, and it shows every single day. Like, it shows when people talk trash about others, when they leave negative comments, when they always have an opinion on someone else's life. Like, all of that stuff just makes it seem like you hate yourself. I don't know how to make the rules. I do not make the rules. That's just what they tell me, okay? But yeah, like I was saying, self-hate is a barrier to self-discovery and personal development. Embracing self-compassion allows us to break free from its grip, fostering a healthier relationship with ourselves and opening the door to a more fulfilling and authentic life. And that's just what I want for myself, okay? Like, I want something fulfilling, I want something authentic, I want the purity of it all. I want it all. And a part of, you know, breaking through this barrier is learning that I can have it all. And it's a scarcity mindset to think that you can't have all of the things that you want in this life, because that's not true. You literally can have everything you want. It's just all about focusing to get there, and I don't know, just being intentional about what you want. If you're not intentional about the things that you want, it's not going to happen. It's not. I'm sorry. And I've learned this through personal experiences, that if I'm not intentional about the things that I want, then it's not going to happen for me, because, I don't know, doing things without having intention is pointless, because you don't know why you're doing it. Having intention is having focus. You know why you're doing it, and it's important to know your why. And I feel like a lot of people don't really know their why, which is why it's hard sometimes to break certain barriers or change certain systems, because you don't even know why you're doing it. But in this project, I am creating a color wheel for my 2D design class, which I'm very excited about. Mixing colors was such a project for me because, like I said, I'm not a big artist. I just started learning the arts, and it has been such a process for me. But I'm grateful, because learning these things has sparked my desire to keep practicing art. And I'm grateful to be learning the basics so that I can, I don't know, just better, just be a better architect and artist in general. Having a good foundation is a great start. It's a very important start. So yeah, that's what this is here. I like these little painting videos, so maybe I'll do more of them. I've also been thinking about starting a Vlogmas series, because I am just learning a lot right now, and I'm trying to focus on myself, focus on the things that I want, and going to get the things that I want. So yeah, that's where I'm at. I really enjoyed this painting session I had, because I got to sit down for an hour straight and just be in the moment, and I love that. But I don't know, in this voiceover, I just think it's important to love yourself, especially if you're all that you have, you know? It's very important. And I've been sick these last few days, this whole week, which is why I sound the way I do, but I'm starting to feel a little bit better. So I just wanted to put up this little video to, I don't know, keep going, even though I haven't been in the best moods or the best vibes. So yeah, this is very pleasing to watch, honestly, now that I'm looking back at it. But this is the end of this video. If you made it this far, please like, comment, subscribe, join the gang, join the sunny side, you know the vibes. And thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to feel a little bit better so I can record more videos for you guys. And yeah, I'm so excited to be here, so grateful. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this small snippet and excerpt of me chatting about self-love and acceptance and compassion. So remember to be yourself, love yourself, love others. Bye.